The Arlington Lions Club has been in existence since 1952, and one of its founding members was the famous Norman Rockwell. The Lions' motto is We Serve, and every year they conduct a host of programs to benefit their communities. COVID presented the group with a new set of challenges, and they rose to the occasion, winning a number of awards for their terrific work. I thought I'd stop in and check it all out.
I'm Bob Wilcox.
Hi, Bob. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I know you well, but tell me anyways.
I'm Project Director Nelson Olinsky for the Arlington Lions Club.
And there's some beautiful things in front of us, so gentlemen, just take it away.
So this year, the Arlington Lions Club won Club of the Year for the entire state of Vermont, District 45.
Had you ever done that before?
Not to my knowledge, no.
That's extraordinary.
So what happened when the world shut down with COVID, we kept coming up with innovating projects. And it wasn't just thinking outside the box because we needed to think safely. So we thought inside the bubble and we expanded that bubble with safe projects. We did Green Up Day socially distanced last summer. We did haunted happenings instead of our annual haunted house.
Right.
So it kept people safe. And we put out trick-or-treating bags for kids and we spaced out the tables so they could come, you know, take photos with the props and everything like that and then move on. But it kept everybody separate and really safe. It helped people make memories. Parents got photos of their kids in costumes with the scary decorations in the background,
right.
It was all hands off, so it was safe. And then come Christmas time, the holiday season, we always do our holiday lights project where we light up all of downtown Arlington. This year we also decided to do a lighted car parade. So a bunch of us got together and we paraded all around town blasting Christmas music and Christmas lights blinking all over our cars. And then we also came up with a holiday lights guided tour map. And everybody registered. We had hundreds of houses in town register. So people could take their time over a couple of weeks and they could go out and do this holiday lights tour and we were spreading joy. At the end, people got to vote for the best house. Red Mountain Engraving here in town was kind enough to donate that trophy. And then last Easter, we came up with a really cool socially distanced project where we hid Easter eggs around at local businesses and we numbered them. So kids had to go to each business and write down the number and, you know, write, you know, I was here kind of thing on their sheet. And at the end, they turned them in and they got Easter baskets. So it kept everybody safe, but it didn't cancel those classic Easter egg hunts that everybody enjoys.
An incredible amount of work, which led to that.
Which led to this.
Congratulations.
So, and it, you know, our Facebook page right now is absolutely killing it. We have, check it out. I mean,
how
seriously.
Many, you tell me, how many?
We get, you know, roughly 7,000, 8,000, 9,000 views a week.
That's amazing.
So we have clubs all over the state and all over the country following us, all these Lions clubs and all these nonprofits. And they're looking at our ideas and they're being inspired by them and they're bringing them back to their own communities, which is big time bragging rights. I mean, we have clubs, Lions clubs from, you know, Scotland and England and China and India, following our little Arlington club, and we really only have 22 members. I mean, imagine what we could do with 200 members, all that we could do for the community.
Which brings up, you're always looking for
new members.
Members. And if they wanted to be a new member, how would they do it?
Oh, check out the Facebook page, shoot us a message. We meet every first and third Thursday of the month.
Okay, so next award, what was this award?
Well, before we go on to this, I'd like to add something about the Lions Club of the Year Award. District 45 gave this award to the Arlington Lions Club because the Arlington Lions Club was one of the only clubs that continued to meet throughout the pandemic.
Got
we
it.
Used Zoom. Like Elson said, we meet the first and third Thursday of the month, and we were Zooming our meetings. So we were still
Excellent.
Getting together. We are continuing our projects. We are staying in touch with each other. And the District 45 thought that the Arlington Lions Club did a great job through the pandemic,
Got
even
it.
With all the other problems.
Okay, gotcha.
So then on to one of the other awards that the district gave to the Vermont Lions, or the Arlington Lions, was for the pull tab contest. And what it was you donate the pull tabs from the top of the cans,
yeah.
And we came in second place. We gathered about 42 pounds of pull tabs. So if you can imagine, the little pull tabs that are a half an inch long, we had 42 pounds. So
That's
that was one
good.
Of the other awards that the district gave us a couple weeks ago up in Manchester.
Congrats on that.
It worked out really well.
That almost sounds as much work as that one, I have to tell you. I know it wasn't, but it sounds like
talking garbage bags full of pull tabs.
Next year we're going for first place with the pull tabs is what we're going to try. We'll see what happens.
But. So then we go to the really, these are, correct me if I'm wrong, these are worldwide extraordinary awards.
Melvin Jones was the founder of Lions Club International, and they've created this Melvin Jones Fellow Award. And what it is for each $1,000 that someone donates to Lions Club International in a particular person's name, they're awarded a Melvin Jones. This Melvin Jones was presented to Nelson a couple of weeks ago. We in District 45 hold a big fundraiser, and this one was held in November. We call it the Super Raffle. And what the proceeds from that do is it goes to a Melvin Jones Award. And this year we had enough money to provide 11 Melvin Jones Awards in the state. And what's required is a letter from someone nominating a particular person for the award is sent into the committee. Then the committee goes through, and I think we had about 30 letters this year that we had to go through. And we picked Nelson as a Melvin Jones recipient. He was given this award at the
Equinox
a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
And this is a worldwide award. Lions Club International is worldwide. There's some 1.4 million Lions Club members worldwide, and I don't know how many clubs. There's quite a few clubs all over the world. So it's a great award to get. And then the second worldwide award was given to me. I am a Melvin Jones recipient. I got my Melvin Jones about 10 years ago, and mine is called the Progressive Melvin Jones. And to get a Progressive Melvin Jones it's an additional $1,000. And there was a group of Lions Club members, including the past members of the Bennington Lions Club, that got together and pooled their money, and they were able to give me a Progressive Melvin Jones Award.
Congratulations.
Thank you. So we had quite a weekend at the Equinox a couple weeks ago.
I have to say to you, how do you top this in the coming year, or is that an awful question to ask? The pressure.
Well, Nelson could get a Progressive Melvin Jones, and I could get a third, I guess, or they could give $10,000 and we could have 10 Progressive Melvin Jones.
Yeah, we're gonna kill it. No worries, Haas. I think you're gonna be amazed, and we're gonna come up with some real curveballs and some surprises.
I think you guys did a wonderful job.
We just have a lot of fun.
And that's the key.
We do have a lot of fun.
Okay, so thanks so much for spending some time with us. We really appreciate it. And congratulations on all this hard work.
Thank you.